What's up, YouTube? Today we have a brand new Galaxy S7 Edge on the table. We're gonna see how durable this thing is, and what situations you'll have to watch out for in everyday life. Let's start with the scratch test. Like always, I have a set of picks that help me determine where the hardness of the screen falls on Mohs Scale of Hardness. I gradually increase the hardness of the picks until I can see scratches on the screen. Now, normal glass would fall around a level 5 on Mohs Scale. Tempered glass, like on the Galaxy S7 Edge, is a tad bit harder. You can see that a level 6 makes a mark, but a level 7 leaves a much deeper groove. This is pretty on par with most major cell phones these days, except for the Droid Turbo 2, which has a plastic, shatterproof screen that scratched at a level 3. You can watch that video if you're interested. Lucky for us, Samsung continued using a glass camera lens. This means that the lens is much more scratch resistant, unlike the plastic lenses on the BlackBerry Priv and the Sony Z5 Premium. Give the Galaxy S7 Edge a thumbs up for the glass camera lens. Now the little heart rate sensor and flash gizmo to the side are protected with a plastic covering. Definitely not as important as the camera lens itself, but at least now you know. It was the same way with the Note 5. If these get scratched up, it's not a big deal. The side of the phone is solid aluminum, so it won't chip or discolor like the older Notes or the plastic Galaxy S5. Now the back panel of the phone is glass as well, and the Samsung logo is printed on the underside of the glass, so you won't have any issues with that rubbing off or chipping out like on the Lumia 950 or with the older Nexus 6. The back glass does scratch a bit easier than the front glass. You can see that my razor leaves some marks on the back, but that same razor leaves the front unscathed. They do sell clear protective covers or skins, so you can protect the back glass if you're into that kind of thing. Let's jump into the burn test. This one always is interesting to me. When some phones are burned with a flame, the pixels turn black and shut off while the flame is in place. Other phones, like this Galaxy S7 Edge, will turn white and never quite recover. Look how reflective that screen is. It is definitely fingerprint central. Speaking of heat, it will be interesting to check out the internal liquid cooling inside this device during my teardown video. I'll slice open that heat tube to see the guts inside, so check out that video. Before we do the bin test, make sure you're subscribed. I've tested 15 phones now, 12 of which survived my bin test, and 3 of which snapped in half like very expensive crackers. Let's see how the S7 Edge holds up. Bending from the back holds up pretty well. When I flip it around and press on the screen though, you can see the back panel lift up just slightly from the frame. Once that seal is broken on the back cover, it is definitely not water resistant anymore. But the phone itself does not break, no matter how I bend it. It is a solid beast of a device. So if you're a heavyset, skinny jean wearing individual, I would not recommend putting this phone in the back pocket of your skinny jeans. It would compromise that water resistant seal. But other than that, this phone is stronger than Donald Trump's hairspray, and that's saying something. It really is one of the strongest, most durable phones I have tested so far. Zero complaints on my end. I post behind the scenes stuff on Instagram and Twitter, so follow me there for updates. Thank you so much for subscribing. You guys make tests like this possible, and I appreciate it a ton. Thanks for watching.